Hello everyone, welcome back to this another Nuke tutorial. And in this one, I'm going to show you how you can add reflections in Nuke. In my last tutorial, I show you how to make reflection in Nuke. In this one, I will show you how you can practically use that in your comp. You can see I have this comp here, and this is exactly the same comp which I did in the past. So this comp is, we are adding this window crack here. So I'm using this one to add a reflection on this glass. So this is the exact comp. If you have this comp, I shared this comp in my Patreon. So if you don't have, you can check my Patreon and you can download this one. If you go on the top, I have this plate here, and here I did camera tracking and all those things here. So, and here is the reflection setup. This is what we saw in the first part to using this Scanline render and this environment light to make a reflection. So I will show you how I did this, and if I show you, and this is with the reflection. So you can see this much reflection I added, and if I play this shot, properly behaving like a reflection. So the reflection is not gonna track, obviously, because it's totally independent, but it will look correct when you add a proper reflection, proper angle, how it gonna, you know, look by the angle. So the angle is very important when you adding a reflection to any surface. So in this one, I keep this more exaggerated, so you can see the reflection while this shot is playing. Okay, so let me just play. You can see, so this is the reflection of this backside, and you may think how I get this backside, because you can see this much area is visible. If you remember, this is action VFX shot, and they have two plates. They shot this car with the two plates. So this one is close one, and we have another plate, this one. So in this one, we can see this entire backside. So I angle this image, so we get a reflection of this side. You can see I'm using this entire image as a frame hold to my reflection. This is my reflection glass. So this is exactly the same plane as we are using here at this window crack here. I mean, I just basically copy pasting this setup and this setup. So this setup is for the roto to get a proper mat. So I'm using this entire setup here also in the up. So this one is this roto setup, and this one is the reflection setup. We get a nice reflection. If I play this one, you can see it's playing very nice and is properly reflection from that image. Obviously, you need a proper HDR to reflect this entire environment. Because we don't have that, you can use this image and you can use this environment light to, you know, get your reflection. And I'm also going to show you how you can use a Rey render. So in the second example, I will show you how to use Rey render to, you know, add reflection. I will show you what is the limitation of using this environment light and what is the benefit of using Rey render in this second example. But first, let's see this first one, and I will create this from scratch. So I'm just leaving this up, disabling this one, but I need to copy some. So I need to copy this setup here, because this is a roto setup and this one is the card. Maybe I need to copy entire thing. So this is the exact setup as I have here in the bottom. So this is exactly same setup. Let's see what we have. So like in my first part, I show you, you can use this specular shader and your card. So this is the card and this is the place of this card. So we have a camera here. So this camera is looking through this. If I go to the camera view, you can see this is the camera angle, and we have another card. This card is for this projection. So we can, you know, do a UV unwrap, and then we can do our roto here, and then we get a proper roto. So this roto is properly match move. So if you want to know more about this thing, so I already explained this in that video. So I'll put a card here, so you can just watch that entire video about the replay, how to add the cracks and how to get this nice roto using this UV projection. All right, so in this one, it's very simple. You need the card, and we just need to add this like this. So this is the proper setup now, and now we need to add a light. So we need that environment light, and we need to add this light into our scene. So this is my scene node. I'm just adding this like this, and if I view it here, you will see nothing. You can only see the alpha, there is nothing. We need to plug the map here. So this is my map, copy pasting this thing here. For HDR, I'm using this one, but if you use any proper HDR map, it will work very nicely. But in this case, this is fine. So let's see what we get. So you can see immediately we see the reflection, but the angle and the position is wrong. So what you can do, we can just go here and I'm rotating this 180. Now we get this angle. Still, this angle is not correct. So instead of using this, if I put a proper HDR map, let me find a HDR and then I will come back. All right, so I found these two HDR which I use in my lot of previous tutorials. So So this is this map and this is this one. Let's see the second one. So this one, so it's very nice and very good map. So it's an 8K map. So instead of this single image, if I use this proper HDR and if you view it here, you're going to see a proper sky reflection. And yeah, so if I explore down, you can see it's giving us properly this cloud reflection, because this is the ground and this is the horizon line, right? So this is angling on top. So you can see, so this, if I go to the camera view, this thing, so if I go to the camera view, if I zoom out a little bit, you can see from the camera view, we can see this is our horizon line and this is sky and this is ground. And similarly, you can see in the HDR also, this is like our horizon line and you can see this is sky, this is ground. So in the reflection, we should see the sky reflection, not the ground. And this is exactly what we are getting here. You can see this cloud, I mean, we are, I think, seeing this cloud right patch here, because you can see this cloud here, right? So we get a proper sky reflection because we have proper HDR. But in this case, we don't have, so I'm using this one. So in this situation, because I'm using this image, obviously I can use this transform, spherical transform, to convert my image. And if I press Ctrl Alt, here you can see the Ctrl Alt and left mouse, you can make this one like HDR. You can do stuff like this. Instead of doing this, what I found, you can just go into the light and you can just rotate and see how, which angle you like, and you can just place this one here. Or what you can do, you can just undo this thing, you can just add a transform here and you can just basically simply rotate how you want, and you can just reposition, you can scale, and I think this is very good. I can see this light and this light is the same. I think this light is there. So what I can do, I can just move this pointer here and move it here, and then I can rotate from that. Now you can see it's properly rotating. So using this, I can just make this a proper straight image, and then from XY I can just move it how we want. So let's see, I place it like this. Now I get a proper reflection. Now I'm adding my mask and doing a mask operation here, so I can cut it properly like this. Then I take another merge, and because this is a reflection and it's act like a reflection path in 3D, so we need to put this on plus mode. So now you can see I successfully added reflection, but I know it's too much, so we can just add a multiply node here after the mask, and we can just reduce the amount how much we want. So in this case I will keep it 0.3, and I don't like this hotspot, so that's why if you see here I also added a transform here. And if you see in this example, I use this reflection, so let's try to do the same. So in this one I need to move this down. Yeah, something like this. So if you see this, so we have this much, and I think now it's very low. We can remove. Now you can see we added a reflection very nicely using Scanline Render and the environment light. And we have this very small setup here. So this is reflection setup, you can say. This is the roto, and this much is reflection. So it's better to have HDR. If you find a good HDR that is very similar to your environment, you can use HDR. Then you get proper accurate reflection. You don't need to do any tweaking, just like I did here, rotation, all those things. It will properly behave like a reflection, properly reflecting, and we get a proper nice result, and we get a separate pass. So this is this, you can use this one. So I will show you what I add. So I add this one. Yeah, it's very similar, just a little difference in the angle. So you get a proper flexibility, how much you need. So just like in my first part, I show you the Rey Render also. So in this one also, I will show you how you can use Rey Render. This environment light is good when you need a, like as the name said, environment light, right? So it will only create a environment light and can get only environment reflection. So let's see if you have any object here. So you're not gonna get a reflection from that object into your plane. So for that, we need to use Rey Render. In this example, you can see I have this glass of water and I'm adding some object here, and we need a reflection on the glass. Because it's a glass, so we need some reflection. You can see I'm using this one. So I'm placing this color wheel. So I want reflection, this color wheel on this glass. So for that, what I did, I took it a cylinder because it's very similar to the glass, just for the reference. And then I using a Rey Render and I'm using a reflection shader. So as I show you in my first part, you can use a reflection shader. So this is only gonna work with Rey Render. So if you have a Rey Render, then it will work. So you can see I'm creating a take a new one, then I will explain what I did. Currently we are not seeing the reflection. I will show you why. Plug these two here, and if I view it here, now you can see we get a reflection and we get our object also, because I merge it here, right? If I remove that, you're not gonna get reflection and you're not gonna see this. And let's connect this one here and let's view it like this. Now let me disable this thing. So we are viewing this thing using here, so we need to do a plus. All right, so now we can see it's looking good. Let's connect the reformat also, so it will properly place. Now you can see the reflection is behaving like here. So I have this edit view here, so I can move this one. So I'm actually moving the glass object because it's not aligned properly. That's fine. So I just want to show you the process. So let me rotate a bit. So this is now a proper true reflection from this object. So if I move this one, you can see reflection also gonna move because it's a reflection faking anything. So it's a proper shader reflection, you can see. So this is now glass this side, and if I move on the other side, you can see how it's looking, the front and back, because we have objects. You can see the reflection is also traveling on the glass side. So this is exactly I want to show you. So in the front one, back one, so we get some artifact. That's fine, because this is not a proper geo for that particular scene. But I just want to show you the point where you can use Rey Render and where you can use your Scanline Render to get a proper reflection, and you can add in your scene. So if you have multiple objects, you can add multiple Rey Render and you can add comp multiple reflection. But I will show you what I did here. If you view it in this Scanline Render, we're not gonna see the reflection part. We only see this one. But what I add this one, we can see the reflection and the actual render. I mean this beauty pass. So in my one, what I did, I go into this AOV tab. We have this AOV tab. First I did click on output AOV, then I remove this AOV from beauty. Currently you don't have any AOVs. We need AOVs for the reflection. So you can see that there is a reflection tab. So I'm just creating a new ref class, click RGB and hit OK. Once you hit OK, you can see this reflection is going to remove. Actually I need to click on, we need to enable this thing. So if I enable, you can see this reflection is now gone, because it's this reflection is now storing in a separate path. We need to go and check here. Now we have this reflection path separately. So this is exactly what I did here. You can see in this one, we are seeing only this RGB layer and the reflection is storing in a separate path. So I just shuffle out the reflection and then I plus this one here. Because the reflection, we need to do a plus operation. Okay, after doing this plus, plugging this one, if I view it here and if I press alpha, you can see we have alpha for this object also. I think we need to remove this thing. So we need to remove this alpha. So for that, what I did, I use Scanline Render to get the proper alpha only for that object. So we get alpha from here. So I can just mask out. So we only have this. We don't need this other thing, because if you put this here and if I over this thing, you can see we see this black thing because there is no RGB. We have alpha. So we need to remove this. So that's why I'm using Scanline Render to remove that part. Now we get these two. So we merge the reflection and we merge the proper RGB, because they both are connected with the same thing. So we can move this and we have a nice reflection and we can play around. This kind of situation, you can use Rey Render, which is very powerful to get a object reflection into another object. And for the environment, you can use environment light. Or you can use Rey Render also, which is working very good also. I already show you in that tutorial. If you personally ask me, I will use Rey Render to get a reflection from a certain object. And for the environment, I can use Scanline Render, because Scanline Render have much more ability. We can add more overscan here. You can add more overscan, which is missing in the Rey Render. There is some trick that you can get with the reformat to get overscan. I will show you this thing in my next tutorial maybe. But for now, you just need to understand there are some limitations in the Rey Render, which is Scanline Render have much more flexibility. That's why we are mostly using Scanline Render to get this projection, just like I show you these vectors and all those things. So if you just need reflection from object, use this one. For environment, use Scanline and environment light. I hope you find useful this video. So I got a few comments about just make a second part to show you how you can use those reflection in the comp. So that's why I am making this for you guys, to show you the practical use where you can use this one. So this is a very good one. You can use here and you can add another plane and you can get a reflection here also. So let me know in the comment, what do you think? If you find this tutorial helpful, please let me know in the comment. Share your suggestion, which tutorial you want next. So thank you for watching. We will see you in a very next one.